Hi, my name is Steve Kinney. I'm the head of front-end engineering at Temporal, and this is a course on testing fundamentals. We'll look at taking the simplest unit test, thinking through all of the edge cases and making sure that we're prepared for it. We'll take DOM nodes and other framework components and make sure that they behave the way that we expect them to when a user interacts with them. We'll look at mocking out randomness and network requests to make sure we can test our components in isolation. Finally, we'll take a look at how to use a browser to test our application and make sure it behaves the way that we expect from the outside in. Use the tools you learn in this course to be able to refactor your code with confidence.
So our mission is to start with, you know, just getting the blood flowing, getting some of these very kind of simple tests in place. I did addition. There's not a lot of like heady, like how am I going to implement these things, right? It is, you take the math operators, you make it work, right? But what we're trying to do is get the rhythm of pulling in something, watching it fail, running the test, going, changing, it's getting that like rhythm in place and seeing it, and then we'll kind of pick it up from there. Again, we've got addition. And so now we want to bring in the rest of the functions along the way. I could also like import them all and then have them as properties on here. Multiply and divide. And we'll write some basic assertions of how this should work. So what I might choose to do here is, again, I turn red because there's no test. Great. It should subtract one number from the other. Seems like a good name. And then we can expect, and if you see me make a boo-boo, you can be like, he must be like working on some like higher level of thinking. No, I'm probably talking while I'm typing. Right, it's probably a boo-boo. So if you see something like that, don't feel free to interrupt me, because talking and typing while standing at a podium leads to mistakes sometimes. Great. Now this one still fails. Why does it fail? Because that function doesn't do anything, right? So we can AB, and then we'll return A minus B. And there is that rewarding feeling as the terminal beneath my editor just turned green for a second. Feels right. And you might be like, I should go ahead and do multiply and divide while I'm in here. I'm like, no, because we're practicing. This is about getting good habits in place, not the fact that you know third grade math, or you know how to make JavaScript do third grade math. Okay, so then we do the same thing, get it nice and red. And like I said, I'm hitting Command S, so I get that feedback as I go along. There are people out there who have stuff autosave all the time. I can't do that. It's not me. It's not who I am as a person. You're welcome to do that. In fact, I think if I change away from this window, it will try to autosave, which I did while I was teaching a workshop, and someone said, you should do that. And I turned that setting on, and I've resented it ever since, and it's never been the day I've turned it off. So it should multiply two numbers. Okay, great. And we go ahead, we put the test in there. And again, mostly this is so that when you write tests later, you're not going, what is the syntax for a test? Because you've done it enough times in a row that all of a sudden you get the muscle memory in place. And so again, we can expect that multiply, anyone have a favorite multiplication? That's a weird ask. Anyone have a favorite number, two favorite numbers they love to multiply? 3 times 2 is 6. It fails again. A and B, and then we'll return A times B. Awesome, awesome, awesome. We'll go ahead and it should divide two numbers. And we'll divide. Divide can always get weird on you, because you can choose to like, you know, it's JavaScript, right? Like, we can get to some weird places with floating point numbers, but we're not going to do that to ourselves right now. We'll say to be 5, fails, and we get it working, right? And that is the effective rhythm. Now, there's some edge cases here that we need to think about, and we will. But let's get the test passed. Before I ruin our day already, I'm just going to get the test passing. Awesome. That's kind of when you hear about like test-driven development, that is the very simple version of it. All the testing stuff we've talked about is well and good until anything non-determinate shows up. Things that are non-determinate, an incomplete list. The current date and time, that tends to change, right? Random numbers, right? In this case, like a UUID is a randomly generated string, right? The goal of a UUID is that there's no such thing as true randomness, yada, 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 whatever, is that no two strings that it generates should be equal, right? In the fullness of time, theoretically, that is possible, but it's like one of those things, if you ran it over and over again for thousands of years, you might get one, but not in any kind of conceivable time period, which is problematic, right? Because here we are just generating an ID as part of this code. Now, I'm going to spoil the end of this workshop now so that I can like prove it at the end, which is you have two ways of handling, or three ways of handling this. Not caring about the parts that are random. That'll work. Making the parts that are not random, not random. Or controlling whether or not they're random, right? Also known as all options. And like we're going to pretend the first two are only on the table, and we'll talk about the third one later. All right, so the first one is just not caring about this ID, right? But this can be a little bit tricky because it's going to be there. And to equal doesn't care if there are additional undefined properties, but if there's a new property that shouldn't be there, it is going to yell at us. Let's verify that. Let's just look at this code real quick, put it in our heads, and then we'll switch over the test. Not a lot going on in this code. We've got this idea of a person. They've got a first name and they've got a last name. If you forget to give one of those, it will throw, right? And otherwise, we generate a random ID that is prefixed with person, just because I felt like it. And we add the first name and the last name to the object. And then we have this full name getter, right? If you've never seen this syntax before, you can just type dot full name and under the hood, it will compute it on the fly. Great. But I've got this test and it's technically skipped right now, which is because it's going to fail. Let's watch it fail. I know you're happy with the green, but we're going to lose it. We're going to lose the green. So let's go ahead. We're going to change it. We're going to hit save. And it fails. Right? But yeah, I made a person with the first name Grace and last name Hopper. That should equal a person. First name Grace, last name Hopper. Why? Okay. Doesn't equal. That doesn't help. Oh, look. We got this extra string. But it's going to be random every time, right? Depending on what's going on, we could do something like, we definitely want to make sure it has an ID, right? That's important. That should be part of the test, right? But you can also do nope, get rid of that zero. And this makes it a little bit more interesting, which is, hey, make a new person. And if I give you the first name Grace and the last name Hopper, right, I better see those coming out the other end. However, as long as the ID is some kind of string, as long as it starts with person dash, then you did your job. Like my code works as expected. Theoretically, it is just a browser that you are controlling with JavaScript. Right? And it pulls up your application and it goes through and it can start hitting buttons and doing things, right? This is one running locally in development. But like we can also take a look at other examples as well, but you can kind of see an individual test in a given case, so on and so forth. Again, the timeline, everything. The important part is let's look at like, other than like a MPX Playwright init, and like a tiny little bit of test files. There's not much that I've written in here, right? But we will talk about one of the problems in a second, which is basically all we're saying is like, fire up the browser, go to the page, right, before each one, right? In this case, it should have the title that we expect, right, in the browser. Go ahead and like, get the input field, create task, find the submit button, type something in, and click. This one, it is a little angry because I've got like 7 with the same title. We will talk about some of those problems in a second. Go find like a heading, right, that has the name of the title within, expect it to be visible on the page.